Hello, hello, and welcome back to Zimco Survival. I'm Brian, and as promised, this is the video on how to sterilize wounds using potassium permanganate. In case you guys did not watch the entrance to this video or read it, make a little bit of a disclosure here. I'm not a medical professional. You should only use these techniques when medical help is not available and will not be available. So, for example, bugging out or apocalyptic scenarios. Potassium permanganate is a dangerous chemical and it can kill you, so make sure that you are prepared and that you know what you're doing when you use it. If medical help is available, you should always go to a licensed medical professional if any of them are still available. Like I said, this video is how to use it in case medical help is no longer an option. So basically, I use potassium permanganate for basically as a wound wash, as a preventative. And then I also use it to cure infected wounds. Now, potassium permanganate can be used, like I said, as a wound wash to deal with infected wounds, but it can also be used to cure fungal infections. So it is a very versatile substance. However, it is also very dangerous. It is an extreme oxidizer. Potassium permanganate has a chemical makeup of KMNO4, which means that it is essentially four oxygen molecules. Think of kind of like hydrogen peroxide on steroids. It doesn't bubble like hydrogen peroxide, but it is extremely potent. It is also an analgesic, I guess. It pulls infections out of the skin as well because it is also a salt. So that's what makes it so effective for treating infected wounds. So let me go ahead and show you guys how it's done. This is my potassium permanganate kit. It basically includes gloves, a couple of masks, the potassium permanganate, and a mixing bottle. It also has these little things right here, which I use to actually scoop out the powder. So, in this case, I will be wearing gloves because I don't want to burn myself with it. It's always good to be careful because the powder itself is very, very caustic and it will burn you if it gets on your skin, so you should always wear gloves. And a mask. Now I think I might, because the wind is starting to pick up, use a mask because you don't want to breathe it in. It takes very little potassium permanganate to cause serious problems. So always make sure that you are careful with it. A woman did die after being exposed to only 100 milligrams of potassium permanganate when it was ingested by accident. So make sure that you are careful with it. The reason I still carry this with me, even though it is as dangerous as it is because it is such an effective antiseptic, I simply can't say no to it. It does work very well. I've used it myself many times, and it does effectively treat infected wounds and fungal infections. So basically, this right here is just an ear cleaner, a plastic ear cleaner, that I use as the scoop for the potassium permanganate. Whoop, spilling out my water. Table is not exactly stable. So what you're gonna do is you're just gonna get the tiniest little bit on there. I don't know how well you guys are gonna be able to see it, but just the tiniest little bit. This is 2 ounces of water. Or was 2 ounces of water. And as you can see the little pink dots there? That's why you gotta be careful with it, because if it does spill, those little dots could burn you. So, that's why you wear gloves. No matter how careful you are with this stuff, there's always a possibility. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna close this up. And we're gonna take and close this up. Alright, I don't know how well you guys are going to be able to see it, but that color right there, that color is what you're looking for. Now this is cold water, so it's going to take a little time for it to fully dissolve, but you want that nice hot pink kind of coloration, and that's going to tell you that it's an antiseptic. Alright, so once it reaches that color and you've mixed it properly, that's what it should look like, a nice hot pink. Now what you can do, and I am going to use this on myself, because I know a lot of people sit there and say, well, if it's so good, why don't you use it? Okay, so basically what I do with it is, if I get a cut or wound, like let's say this one right here, I'll take and I'll put potassium permanganate on it like that, rub it around, and just let it dry. That's if the wound is not infected. Now, if the wound is infected, I'll take some gauze. It can be gauze or any clean cloth, really, because all you're trying to do is hold the potassium permanganate in place long enough to pull the infection out of the wound. So what I'll do is I'll put it on the wound, take the potassium permanganate, and soak the gauze with the solution. Thoroughly soak it. Just like that. And as you can see, it is pink. Now, when the potassium permanganate is completely done, it will turn yellow, as the potassium permanganate literally oxidizes the gauze. Once it's fully oxidized, it will have done its complete action and pulled the infection out of the wound. So I'm just going to leave it here like this and try to show you guys the color change as best I can. I don't know how well it's going to work, but I'll try to speed this section up for you. All right, it has turned yellow. I don't know how well you guys can see it, but it went from pink to this kind of tannish yellow color. That means that it has completely oxidized. The potassium permanganate has now oxidized and it is no longer effective. So when it turns that yellowy color, that means that it's done. Now you can add more potassium permanganate to it and extend the time, but I've never really needed to do that very much. I had to do it once when I had a series of scratches all over my arm because of my iguana, and every single one of them got infected. So I did have to use do it twice that time, but normally I don't have to. But there you go. Let's see if I can show it to you a little bit better. I don't know how well you're gonna be able to see it, but you can see that yellow color to the gauze. That's how you know it's done. Now, the only reason you're using gauze for this purpose to treat infected wounds is because you want to hold the potassium permanganate in place in a quantity large enough to actually pull that infection out. If you're just treating a standard wound that isn't infected yet, you can do what I showed you at the beginning and just kind of put it on, rub it on, and just let it dry. And that'll be enough to kill any bacteria that might be in the location. But there you have the gauze. That's what you use. That's what I use when I actually get an infection. Now, this is something I actually do. I'm not just making a video about it. This is something that I actually do at my house using potassium permanganate. Now, like I said, I'm not a medical professional, and you should definitely go and see a medical professional anytime you think you're gonna, with any wounds or anything like that, especially if they're infected. I'm just stubborn, so I try to treat everything myself. But you should always make sure you see a medical professional. So there you have it. That is how you use potassium permanganate to treat infected wounds. And that right there is why, no matter how careful you are, always make sure you have protection. But thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.